Hi guys. It is after 11 o'clock at night on a big exciting Saturday night here in the collapse of global industrial civilization here in the social isolation chamber of Garfield, Texas here on Saturday night, March 28th, 2020. And so this is, I guess, the new, I don't know, what am I now? This is Sam Mitchell. I guess more and more people are now labeling me, you know, the new Alex Jones right-wing, fear-mongering, conspiracy wacko, talking, you know, crazy talk about the police state, blah, blah, blah. So this was your old crazy... your old crazy right-wing fearmonger about 12 hours ago. And let's listen to this crackpot for a minute and then check in with the latest Yahoo News story coming out in the last hour. Take it away, right-wing fearmongering crackpot conspiracy wacko. Well, that was great. I'll try this again.
This thing, and my big question is, I don't know. Will they lock down the interstate highway system? Will, in the next few weeks, will we not be allowed to travel to other states? I guess they would enforce that by license tags. I give it a 50-50 that in the next month that the interstate highway system will be locked down, which is really the main one, the main social control mechanism is to shut down the interstate highway system. So if you have the ability in your life, if you know you need to be in a state other than where you're at, you need to be making plans to do that.
Okay, that was 12 hours ago. 12 hours ago, I was giving it a 50-50 that you were going to see state by state lockdowns based on license plates. And then I open up NBC News. Wow. Since I made that that great prediction, Rhode Island officers stopping incoming New Yorkers to force quarantine. Huh. Imagine that. Rhode Island's National Guard and state police are stopping motorists with New York license plates and going door to door to find people who may have traveled recently from the state. The enforcement actions come after Governor Gina Raimondo ordered that anyone who has moved from New York State to Rhode Island in the past 2 weeks must self-quarantine for 14 days, part of her state's efforts to slow the spread of coronavirus. Troops from the National Guard have been posted at train stations and bus depots to inform New Yorkers of the order, and on Saturday, today, they began going door to door to tell any recent travelers from New York that they must follow the quarantine. State police began stopping cars with New York plates on Friday. So this actually, I guess I had a post prediction. What is the name of making a prediction the day after something happened? Said the governor, "I know this is unusual, I know this is extreme, and I know some people don't agree with it. It is absolutely not a decision I make lightly, close quote. Those who do not comply with the order face a fine of $500 and 90 days in prison. 90 days in prison. The governor's order to stop New Yorkers drew a complaint from the state's chapter of the American Civil Liberties Union. This is Stephen Brown, head of the ACLU in Rhode Island. Quote, while the governor may have the power to suspend some state laws and regulations to address this medical emergency, she cannot suspend the Constitution. Well, like hell she can't. She just did. Under the Fourth Amendment, having a New York State license plate simply does not and cannot constitute probable cause to allow police to stop a car and interrogate the driver, no matter how laudable the goal of the stop may be. Close quote. Raimondo said she understood the ACLU's argument that she did not have the right to upend the United States Constitution, but she said that directive follows federal guidance and will be enforced respectfully. The White House had previously called for all people who leave New York to self-quarantine for 14 days. Said Raimondo, this is the law. This is not a suggestion. It's going to save lives. So once again, guys, it doesn't matter whether you agree that the governor of a state should be able to suspend the U.S. Constitution in the time of what some people consider an emergency. I am simply using this as an example of what is going to be happening more and more, that this is clearly what is going on with this coronavirus thing, this corona panic, as more and more things like the corona panic and things a whole hell of a lot worse than the corona panic start to unfold in the coming, I almost shudder to say, years or decades, that more and more you are going to see, whether you agree with it or not, I'm just pointing out, you can expect the U.S. Constitution to be under more and more fire. That the literally the police state, you can expect to have the National Guard pulling you over because of your license plate. This is a no-brainer. Whether you consider this a good or bad thing is irrelevant to the conversation. I am simply pointing out to anybody who cares that this is going into overdrive, and that we are entering a whole new level of police state, whatever you want to call it. It is here. What was this one comment I did like? So after that thing that I just put out there, I love, sounds like Sam is getting sick of free exchange of ideas on a public message board. Yes. Where is this comment? someone says I might as well. Okay, Jerry Irwin. Now, I have interviewed Jerry Irwin. Jerry Irwin is a prepper. I'm totally confused, Jerry, by your comment here. You can find my interview with Jerry Irwin. Jerry Irwin is the last person I expected this comment from. And so maybe I'm misunderstanding it. Oh, please, Sam, not the conspiracy stuff about martial law. I might be getting mobilized myself out of my retired status. Got my email from Army HRC a couple of days ago. So I think Jerry is being sarcastic here. Oh, please, Sam, not the conspiracy stuff about martial law. I'm assuming, Jerry, you're being ironic and that what you're saying is good for you, Sam, talking about the police state. But I don't know anymore, guys. I am so confused at this point. But one thing I'm not confused about is we are heading into a police state, and the police state that you're seeing unfolding as a response to the level of threat of the coronavirus once again compared to what is coming down the pike will be a bad hair day. And I'm going to start sounding like Alex Jones probably the next one of these things. Anyway, it's getting on midnight. I got to go to bed and publish my coronavirus-free interview with Lier Keith. So be sure, if you do not want to hear the word coronavirus mentioned for a full hour, please tune in to my interview with Lier Keith coming right up on Collapse. This is Coronavirus Chronicles. You'll have to go over to Collapse Chronicles to find that interview with Lier. Bye, guys.